Brothers.
Good morning, McGraw.
All right. Yesterday, or I should say Friday, we were down just a tad. What was the story on Friday?
Oh, yeah. Friday, the Dow was down 41 points, closed at 24,232, a quiet end to the most volatile day in over a year for the Dow. We were off over 350 points on an erroneous report, but it was corrected, and we fought back to end with a small loss. The last time the market had this much extreme swings was the Brexit vote in June of 2016. Investors still bought the safety of the 10-year U.S. Treasury, taking the yield down to 2.36%.
Wow, that's interesting. All right. Company news. What is the ISM Manufacturing Index?
Yeah, the ISM Manufacturing Index, now that came in at 58.2, down from 58.7 in October, but above the 57.3 average we had over the past 12 months. A reading over 50 suggests expansion, and we've been well over that for a while now. Factory orders, or factory inventory shrank at the fastest pace in a year, indicating several more months of expansion. And employment in the manufacturing sector is near a six-year high. So that's all good news.
All right, there. Now, the blockbuster news over the weekend. CVS wants to buy an insurance company, Aetna?
Yes. We've been talking about it for a while, but now it's official. CVS is buying Aetna for $69 billion. This will bring the number three U.S. insurer and a big provider of pharmacy business under one roof. They plan to use their 9,700 pharmacy locations to provide customers with more local care options. The deal is part stock and part cash and is a 29% premium to where Aetna was before discussions were disclosed, and it's the largest deal of the year. So,
that's a blockbuster move. That's a game changer right there, CVS buying Aetna. We'll wait and see how that ripples throughout the rest of pharmacies and insurance companies and everything else. And then finally, what are the people saying about the tax bill that passed the Senate on Friday?
Right, yeah. Over the weekend, the Senate passed a major tax bill, but still needs to get together with the House of Representatives. The two will work on differences between the bills, including a new system to tax pass-through businesses, what the corporate tax rate will be, and the new rules on international business. After this, the president needs to sign the bill, but many think it will be in place before the end of the year.
All right. Scott Crothers, markets today. What do you think?
Today, the Dow looks up 220 points on optimism over the new tax bill. It will be a very busy week with all the tax policy negotiations, but we also get factory orders today and ISM service report tomorrow. Later in the week, we get employment numbers with the big employment report on Friday.
Scott Crothers, thanks for checking in. Thanks for putting up with us, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.